Hello guys, welcome to my 7th class of Universal Laplace Transform. We discussed already in the 6th class of Universal Laplace Transform, what's the statement of convolution theorem, what's the definition of convolution of two functions. Now, I discussed one problem based on convolution theorem, how to solve with help of convolution theorem. Now, I'm going to take another one problem, say, I have to find out the inverse of a square square plus a square whole square by using convolution theorem. Now, I told already in my previous video, if you want to go for convolution theorem, first you have to choose two product of two functions. Now, I am going to take let capital F of x is nothing but s by s square plus a square, and also I am going to consider what is my g of s's 1 by s square plus a square. Once you choose the product of two functions, observe carefully, this is a standard result. What is the L inverse of this function is cos a t. What is L inverse of this is 1 by a sin a t. Therefore, no issue. Suppose that you choose the given function in the product of two functions, immediately we get the corresponding inverse value. Therefore, I am going to use which theorem? Convolution theorem. Before going to take convolution theorem, first you find out the corresponding inverse function value. It's nothing but L inverse of s by a square plus a square. What is this value actually? Cos a t. What is this cos a t? It's nothing but my f of t. Okay. Next is L inverse of g of s is nothing but L inverse of 1 by a square plus a square. What is this actually? Sin a t. Which one is missing? A. Therefore, 1 by a to multiply by 1 by a. Sin a t. That is nothing but g of t. Next step, we are going to use convolution theorem. Okay. Now, L inverse of s by s square plus a square whole square is nothing but 0 to t f of u. What is my f of t? Is already written here, cos a t. F of u is nothing but cos a u. What is my g of t? G of t is sin a t. 1 by a. 1 by a is a constant. Therefore, I take it outside. 1 by a of sin of a into t minus u with respect to u. Now this can also be written as 1 by a 0 to t cos a u sin of a t minus a u. I take it u is inside the bracket du. This is just like product of two trigonometry functions. We don't have any formula to integrate directly. Now, I will go for transformation formula. Just like cos A sin B. What is cos A sin B for transformation formula? Half of, you already studied in pure level. Half of, what about that? Sin of A plus B. Sin of A plus B minus sin of A minus B. Minus sin of A minus B. Because sin of A plus B sin A cos b plus cos a sin b minus of sin a cos b minus cos a sin b. Then simplify that, we get this. From this, what is cos a u into sin of a t minus a u? Keep in mind, my e, this is my a, this is nothing but my b. It's nothing but half of sin of a plus b, a u minus a u is cancel. A plus b, what happened here? A u plus a t minus a u. What's the remaining? Sin a t minus sin of a minus b. A u minus of a t. Are you okay now? Minus a u. What we get actually? Minus a t minus plus 2 a u minus a t. Now we get sin of what actually? 2AU minus AT with respect to, this is nothing but sin of what actually? AU into sine of AT minus AU. Therefore, L inverse of S by S square plus A square whole square is nothing but R. To get 2, 1 by A already is there, 1 by 2A, 0 to T of sine AT minus sine of 2AU minus AT with respect to U. With respect to U. In the next step, now I am going to integrate term by term. What's integration of sine AT? This is a simple function, therefore I will do it directly, minus cos AT divided by, what is the quotient of T is A. What's the limit? 0 to T. Minus, what is integration of sine is minus cos of 2AU minus AT divided by, what is quotient of U is 2A. Limit is what? 0 to T. In the next step, 1 by 2A. I'll keep minus 1 by A as a constant. Apply the upper limit. What's upper limit? Cos AT. Minus cos 0, lower limit. What is cos 0? Is 1. Minus into minus plus 1 by 2A is a constant. Apply the upper limit. What is upper limit here? T. Instead of here, I'm going to take T. 2AT minus AT. What do we get? AT. Means cos AT. Minus cos 0. Oh, whatever u is 0. U is 0, what happened? Cos of minus 80. What is cos of minus theta? Cos theta. Therefore, we get cos of theta. Please try to understand for this. Minus e to minus plus. I'll keep the constant outside. Put a is t. 280 minus 80 is cos 80. Put u is 0. What's the remaining? Cos of minus theta. Cos of minus 80 is cos 80. Therefore, these two are cancelled. What we get actually now? 1 by 2a square at multiply by minus sign. 1 minus cos 80. This is the answer of the given function by using which theorem? Convolution theorem. Whenever is possible, I have to convert the given f of s in the product of two functions, and also we get immediately that value. Better I have to go for convolution theorem. Easily we get. The another one point we have to remember, just to find inverse of the given function, is not mentioned anything. Suppose it's possible, I have to convert product of two functions, you convert apply convolution theorem. Or you do it any other alternative method. But suppose they mention in the problem, I have to solve convolution theorem, you can't go for any alternative method. I go for this method only. Please keep in mind. Now, I'll complete that this thing. If you want some more problem, you please go to my website, KMR Bitmaths. Yeah, then there we get forms or docs. If you want to download full my whatever notes material. Okay, let us go to the last topic of inverse Laplace transform. Inverse Laplace transform, the last topic is in how to solve linear differential equations by using Laplace transform. That is a very, very important concept. This is an application of Laplace transform. Anybody had to ask whether you know any application based on Laplace transform? Yes. We know that how to solve linear differential equation by using Laplace transform, also inverse Laplace transform. Now, the thing now I have to solve differential d means d dot e, everyone is familiar, differential equation, linear differential equations. Equations using LT. LT means what? Laplace transform. Now I am going to explain how to solve the differential equation by using Laplace transform. Another one point I have to remember, I told in my first video of Laplace transform, if you want to solve any linear differential equation, you can't find out general solution. Only the possibility is I have to find out particular solution. Means, if you want to solve linear differential equation, they are expecting boundary conditions. Without boundary condition, you can't proceed. You can't find out, fail to give Laplace transform, whatever solving a differential equation. That's a drawback for Laplace transform. Now, if you want to solve linear differential equation, first I'm going to write some set of formula I'm not going to derive that formula. Here I have to solve. How to solve? I'm going to explain little of this formula. If you want to know in depth how we get this formula, you refer any ordinary textbook for Laplace transform. Easily you have to understand how we get this. Laplace transform of y dash of t means y is a first derivative. What's the meaning of derivative of y with respect to t? Is nothing but s into Laplace transform of y of t minus y of 0. Okay. The next is not only have a first derivative, maybe having a second derivative is nothing but a square into Laplace transform of y of t minus s into y dash of 0 minus y of 0. Similarly, Laplace transform of triple dash of the third derivative is nothing but s cube into Laplace transform of y of t minus s square into y double dash of 0 minus s into y dash of 0 and then minus y of 0 and then minus y of 0. So on is possible to write the derivative. I think you know that how to write fourth derivative of Laplace transform is s to the power of 4 l of I t minus s cube into triple dash of 0 minus s square into double dash of 0 minus s into y dash of 0 minus y of 0. This is the way to proceed. Yes, thank you very much for listening my talk. Now I am going to solve in my next video how to solve ordinary linear differential equation by using Laplace with the help of these formula. Okay, thank you. Suppose you like my talk, you please press a like button and also subscribe my channel. Thank you.